The world is filled with brave people. The world is also filled with stupid people. And both types provide some pretty shocking video from time to time. What's up, everyone? Welcome back to The Supreme. I'm your host, Maddie Wills, and today we'll be exploring the world of scary and intense videos that display some of our craziest, scariest, and strangest behavior from people to animals and everything in between. Today's title is The Scariest Videos That Simply Shouldn't Exist. Want to become part of the Supreme Team? Make sure to subscribe down below with notifications on so you don't miss anything we post each day. Let's get rolling. Snake recovery. So our first clip of the day displays something that's kind of unsettling. In this clip that was captured from somewhere overseas, you can see a couple of guys walking around in some shallow waters, where it appears that they're trying to pull something out from beneath the water. The guy with no shirt and in the orange shorts actually disappears beneath the surface of the water in what looks like an attempt to dislodge whatever is stuck down on the ground. After a few moments, you can see something kind of stick out from beneath the water, but it's not very clear what it is. Just keep watching. The guy in the shorts suddenly pops up. Then, when the camera refocuses, the two guys together continue to yank on the cord and eventually manage to pull up a super long, massive snake. What in the world is going on here? Why would these guys be looking to pull a snake out of the stream? Unless this was an attempt to relocate the large slithering animal, I can't think of any other reason why anyone would want to risk their life for an animal of this size. Luckily though, for these two gentlemen, nothing really bad happens. Let's just hope they manage to move this humongous snake without any injury to any person or any injury to the snake, of course. Lumbering big fella. So before we're able to move on to the next clip, which is a big deal, we've got to pause for a quick moment to show a little love to one of our most recent viewers. Today's special shout out goes to none other than KS Wonderland, who just the other day, after watching one of our videos, left a comment saying, "Hey, I love your videos. Hashtag Supreme Family. I could spend all my day watching your videos." Hey, KS, guess what? If you wanted to spend a whole day watching our videos, well, we wouldn't be mad about that at all. There are certainly enough of them out there. So thanks for watching and thanks for the comment. And don't forget, as soon as today's video is done, we're already working on one for tomorrow. So don't hesitate to swing on back by. So how close have you ever been to a bear? No, I don't mean the one behind fencing and ropes at your local zoo. I mean a real wild bear. Hopefully not too close, as these animals could turn on you in an instant, especially if they're hungry. But check out this next clip that features a bear, an extremely large one at that, slowly lumbering through an area that's filled with wooden cabins. You can even hear the guys shooting the video commenting on just how massive in size this big brown bear is. And luckily for them, they're inside. And it's when the big mammal wanders past the picnic tables that you can see just how big he really is. Luckily for these boys, the bear just continues on, paying no attention to his audience. But then there's a guy walking the trail up ahead that appears to be none the wiser that the massive apex predator is only a few hundred feet behind him. Lounging big fella. From one giant bear that looked to be getting his exercise, to another giant bear that appears to want to take a nap. Check this clip out. That features another one of those large animals just sort of hanging around underneath someone's porch. The guy who owns the house obviously didn't want the animal to stay there, so he took the situation into his own hands when he started to startle the bear in hopes of making it get away from the area. So I hope it goes without saying that we definitely don't recommend having a face-to-face showdown with a wild animal of this size, but hey, this guy must have felt comfortable doing it. After a bunch of strange noises, the guy actually managed to get the bear to move his hangout to another area. Luckily, he didn't get into an actual physical confrontation, because I just don't see that ending as peaceful as this one did. Do you want to get a shout out in one of our daily videos? Well, don't forget to drop a comment down below with the hashtag Supreme Family. Tomorrow could be your day. Now, let's get back to the topic. Look both ways. So enough from the animals for just a moment. Let's focus on a human who, well, needs to pay more attention. It's no secret that car accidents have risen dramatically since the invention of smartphones. Just ask any car insurance company. but it's a wonder when we come across videos that show some crazy driving that doesn't involve the vehicle's operator being distracted by their phone. This time around, the person crossing the street was clearly in the wrong. Check it out. On a busy road one morning, someone needs to cross the street by any means necessary, apparently. Then, whoa! Talk about a near collision. Luckily, the pedestrian was injured during this mad dash. Moving forward, though, hopefully they've learned to look both ways before they cross the street. Mama Raccoon. Moving on, in this next clip, we get back to the animals, and this story is crazy. So in the spring of 2018, this woman started to suspect there was something happening in her closet that she wasn't aware of. After her husband left on business one day, she began hearing strange noises coming from upstairs. After a little investigating, this is what she discovered. A mama raccoon was moving in her newborn babies. And not only that, but she was entering and exiting the home through the dog's door. What in the world? After discovering this, she quickly had the animals removed. But it's almost hard to be mad at a mama raccoon just looking after her babies. Well, isn't it? Look both ways, please. So a few moments ago, we showed you a perfect example of why you should look both ways before you cross the street. In this next clip, we'll double down on that suggestion, as another near miss could have ended up being a lot worse than it actually was. Again, we're overseas, where it appears that a public bus is either stopped or malfunctioning. You'll see a woman come running from around the right side of the stopped vehicle, and without really looking, appears to be ready to jet across the street. Unfortunately, however, there's a large truck coming at the same time. Now, all this poor woman had to do was pause for a moment and look to her left and to her right, but she didn't. And this is the result. Whoa, I don't know how she didn't lose her nose. That's how close she was. So, guys, please, please, look both ways before you cross the street. Falling rocks. We'll keep it moving. Up next, we've got footage that definitely could have gone left real quick, but luckily, everyone was okay. So check this out. A crowd has gathered to witness the demolition of this abandoned building. Now, at first glance, it appears that these people are at a safe distance from the debris, doesn't it? Well, not so much. Check it out. After the building is brought down to earth at what appears to be several hundred feet away from the crowd, a falling rock that was blasted off of the concrete comes flying towards the group of people at a very high rate of speed. Whoa, did you see that? Now, luckily, no one was hit or hurt by the debris, but can you imagine what would have happened had that connected? That would have been a big problem. Biggest rat ever in China. So I know we've been all over the place in today's episode, and I guarantee you that nothing you've watched so far has prepared you for this. Now, when it comes to house pets, I know that us humans can get creative. Oh yeah, we have plenty of dog and cat lovers out there. We even have people that enjoy owning reptiles like snakes and lizards. But what about a rat? I know some of you out there enjoy those as well, but what if that rat was bigger than a dog? Check this out. This rat was captured over in China, and holy cow, holy rat, this thing is huge. Just what in the heck is in the water over there? Can you imagine coming downstairs to the kitchen in the middle of the night for a drink of water and coming across something this big? I mean, is this a joke? I'm not even kidding. This is one of the most hideous mammals I've ever seen. And if it were in my house, forget animal control, I'm calling the police. Tarantula. Since we're talking about things that would scare the living daylights out of you if you saw it in your home, up next we've got another hairy creature that was actually recovered after it scurried across someone's kitchen floor. Check out this big tarantula. And the guy that caught it put it in a bin next to a penny just so you could see how big it really was. Now, who remembers an old movie called Arachnophobia? It's basically a movie about killer spiders. Are we so sure that this guy didn't belong in that film? Apparently, the homeowner lives in northern Arizona, so let's just say that we'll knock that area down a few pegs on my list of wishful places to live. I'm just not ready to go to war with a spider that looks like this. Nope, not me. Teasing crocs. So, when we opened up this video today, I suggested that animals can be scary, but also us humans can be stupid. Case in point, when we try to tame wild animals and think that just because we taught them a couple of tricks, then they're completely under our control. History has proven over the years that this isn't always the case, as sometimes wild animals, no matter how much human interaction they may have had, simply will resort to what their brain tells them to do every now and again, especially when they're threatened and especially when they're hungry, which all makes this final clip a bit more impressive, as this guy can be seen hand-feeding alligators for whatever reason. Check it out. Now, how much would we have to pay you to do something like this? Me? Oh, I don't think there's any amount of money that would get me to climb into water and hand feed a crocodile. Nope, not me. I ain't gonna do it. And that's today's video. If you like today's video, leave a thumbs up and share it with all your friends. Also, don't forget to subscribe to this channel so that you never have to miss out on any of our interesting videos ever again.